This is Ward and Al on Canada Talks.
All right. Sean Prue is filling in for Al.
It's true.
She's out today, taking a sick day. But we're in luck because Sean has actually interviewed the best-selling author who is sitting in with us now.
Miranda Esmond White is one of America's greatest advocates and educators of healthy aging. She says our bodies are designed to be pain-free through our lives, but to achieve that, we have to move. When I last interviewed her, it was for her book, Aging Backwards. Her new book, Forever Painless, Lasting Relief Through Gentle Movement, is available now. How did you write? I feel like it was just like 2 minutes ago that I was last talking to you, and you've written another book.
Oh, well, thank you for inviting me, first of all. And writing a book is of this nature. It's a collaborative exercise.
And one that's obviously sort of right on time. I was talking to my partner this morning who is in pain because he doesn't like his bed. He says he's blaming it on his bed. But before he woke up this morning in pain, he had back pains because he lifted a box the wrong way. He seems to always be in pain.
Yeah.
And this is symptomatic of a society that doesn't move enough, I think, and exercise enough.
Right.
And you say symptomatic.
It is definitely symptomatic of not moving enough and not moving correctly, because the human body is designed to move. We all move. We're born moving. We have 360 joints, and each of those joints is designed to move.
Mm.
So if we don't move, then the joint itself will send a message to the brain saying something's
Hello.
Going wrong.
Yes.
And that's called pain. So
we live in a society, I find, and Ward, you can tell me whether this is true for you or not, but I have a friend who lives down the street from me. I'm talking two blocks, and he will get in his car to come to my place.
Please don't tell me.
Yes.
Yes.
You know that already. You wouldn't have written this book.
Right. Well, one in five people suffer from chronic pain.
Mm.
That's pain that's lasted more than 3 months. And that's something is wrong with the mechanics of our body. And if, as your friend is getting in his car, he's not using his body. We have, 650 muscles and 360 joints, and they all have to move, or they will become unbalanced and lead to shoulder pain or knee pain or fibromyalgia, all kinds of
pains. I'm also convinced, and listener, I'm tapping the top of my laptop, that we are glued the trance hypnotic power of our screen so often, and we sit there and hours go by, and I've caught myself so many times deep in a project, and I sit down at this weird angle to start just typing a quick thing, and hours later I'm still at this weird angle, and
I blame my laptop. I blame it on my, I know it's because of that I've developed bad posture.
Mm-hmm.
And we also
also
have bad neck habits now as North Americans by looking down at our computers and our computer screens.
It's all repetitive motion that isn't reversed. Like, we do have to look at our computers. I'm a writer. I'm always on my computer.
Yes.
So you have to do movements that reverse
that give
forward
me that one.
Move.
Give me that one.
So
put
you
our
have
hands
to
up in
reverse the computer
Whoa.
Movement by pulling the arms behind you. So you can work on your computer and sit this way as you are, a little sort of off balance. And then you have to do exercises that will just rebalance the other side. And it takes easy 5 minutes, and then you're done.
Well, it's funny that you say that. We talk about people needing to stretch and do certain movements because of the fact that we become so sedentary and we don't move enough. But then there's people like myself. I've actually developed some pain issues and some joint and posture issues, not because of my not moving. Well, part of it was that. And many of our listeners are truckers, many of them.
Okay.
So you're talking about people that are behind the wheel. And that was me. I was traveling full time. Behind the wheel of a car for hours on end. And in the car, we don't sit like you look in the TV commercials. You sit in a way that's comfortable in that car for a moment or for that time you're in it. But you're often doing damage to your body while doing that.
Right.
A lot of the truckers out there know this. Many of them have said they developed chronic pain over the years of being behind the wheel, sitting behind the wheel.
Because you're sitting in... Not you're kind of wiggling like this in a truck, you know, you're twisting a bit, but not much. So you're not moving the sideward motion mm-hmm. of your legs and of your body, or the rotational motion of your spine. You're basically shortening up one whole group of muscles in the front of your body, and you're lengthening the other side.
What can they do if they're listening right now yeah. and they can relate to the description Ward's given? What would you suggest someone like that do? Because your book, Forever Painless, Lasting Relief Through Gentle Movement, suggests that there is a way to cure yeah. this pain through
right.
gentle movement.
So what they need to do is to just, when they have a break, like let's say we're talking about truckers, or we're talking about people sitting at a computer.
Yes, which is everybody listening right now.
One or the other yeah. is probably, you know. So you need to stand up and reach towards the ceiling and do, just free up all your joints.
I'm going to do this right now.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay. Let's do it.
Okay.
Let's do this.
So all right, Sean's actually standing. I'm just in my seat.
Can I stand? Is this okay?
Yes, you may.
Okay. So just lift your arms above your head.
What the heck, I'll do it too. All right. Okay. We're all standing. They're standing in the booth too. Cassandra's...
Oh, good.
Are you standing?
Okay. So stand up and now lift one arm higher.
What?
Ooh,
I have an Audi.
Okay. Reach one arm higher.
Sean just saw my
right up. Okay, now stay there.
Yeah.
All right,
now
so we're
relax
stretching. We're up.
Oh, wow. And go higher. Now stay there and relax more. And now reach higher.
Oh, it hurts.
See how it's going through? You can one arm at a time.
Oh.
So
oh,
go
okay
up now. Relax.
Guys,
relax
dude,
and go higher. And go higher.
Okay,
and
we're
relax.
Going higher.
Relax.
Okay, right.
As you go up. Relax as you go up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay. Change arms.
Okay. All right. Stretch. Change it up.
Reach up now. Relax your shoulders. Relax your back.
Okay. Reach up with one arm and then relax the rest
relax
of you.
Relax your whole body, right
yeah
down the side of your body. Now go higher, staying relaxed.
It's easier on one side than the other.
Yeah, because the side it's harder on is the side that's unbalanced. So it's yeah. So you're not going high enough. Work those ribs. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, you've got a lot of tension there in your sides. Okay. Now pull it behind you. Just a little. Relax. Relax. Don't work so hard.
Don't leave me yeah ever, Miranda.
I will. We've
okay
locked the door.
Come be my roommate.
And
we are speaking to Miranda Esmond White.
Pull behind.
The new book is called Forever Painless. And it's great because it's it's everything from a fitness book to a coffee table book.
I'm untucked. To and my microphone has fallen off its stand, but boy, do I feel better.
But the book is it's great because it is a really good guide to some basic stretching techniques, things you can do to relax. The thing I'm saying that I am one of a growing number of people. I was reading about this recently. That has pain issues mm-hmm and joint issues mm-hmm and posture issues, mm-hmm, not because of being sedentary, but because I exercised and lifted weights for many years and didn't stretch. And because of that, I've done damage over the years
right
to my joints and my knees because I was lifting heavy weights. You looked at me and everyone goes, wow, he's fit and
he's
everything
gorgeous
like that.
Yeah.
All that. But on the inside,
it's all, mm-hmm, it's all being compressed.
Mm-hmm. I've got a tilted pelvis now.
Oh, you can free it. These exercises will completely liberate it.
Well, I need
so
that.
Let me explain to you that they're not all stretching is the same.
Yeah.
So to stretch right up until eccentrics, this program, and I explained it in the book. So basically, I've discovered the correct way to stretch.
Right.
And so that's what I'm teaching. That's what the whole eccentrics program is about. So eccentrics means to lengthen while you're strengthening. So even if you had stretched, it wouldn't have done you any good because most people, right up until this program was developed, did passive stretching.
Mm.
So as you just stretch, target a muscle and stretch it out. And then the moment you move, you have to use strength to move. Everything needs strength to move. So that stretched out muscle would immediately tighten again to move. So what you need to do is strengthen your muscles in that lengthened position. And then the joint will be decompressed. So all your joints are compressed. So what this program does is it will make you move. Okay, so here we go again. Up you get.
Okay,
I'll
right
show you how this works.
All right, I'm up.
Okay, so you're going to lift your arm again above your head.
Okay.
Feet apart so that you won't fall over. Now, bend sideways. So you're going to just bend over sideways. Now pull your arm more.
All right.
Okay, now bend more over. Okay, now are you feeling you're bending?
Yeah.
Now, wider lunge. Okay, now bend further and reach your arm further. So these muscles are being stretched, but they're
feels
also
so
being
good,
strengthened. They're being strengthened. They're being strengthened in the stretched position. So they will then remain that way.
Right.
And so what we're doing right now is going to decompress your spine, because the muscles along the side of your body are indirectly and directly connected to the vertebra. So, all right. You know, all these lifting and loading, because your body is a weight. Like, yeah. You weigh something. So if you were to bend over and right. relax, you'd fall to the floor. So by the fact that you didn't collapse to the floor meant that you were using strength.
I collapsed to the floor. You didn't see me, but I did.
Yeah, Sean fell.
I have a question for you, and I'm not talking to the V. Cassandra, we're going to need someone to help with the mic. Oh, there it is. The mic fell when I was first doing my exercises, and we put it back together backwards. So aww. I'm speaking backwards into the mic now.
It's just another, it's a great exercise moment. For the ribs.
So I was talking to my mother on Sunday, Miranda, and she said she's been diagnosed with arthritis.
Okay.
Now, what would you do if you were her?
She needs to do what we've been doing. You have to reverse arthritis. Arthritis, rheumatoid, and osteo. Osteo is the bones grinding together, and rheumatoid is when the bones are swollen from the immune system. So rheumatoid is when your immune system is actually attacking your bones and makes them swell. So both of these can be assisted by pulling the joints apart, which is exactly what we just did. We took the rib bones and we pulled them apart as we bent over. So she has...
She's feeling it in her foot, of all places.
Very common. Okay. Arthritis attacks our hands and our feet first.
Okay.
So she is like right on target.
All right.
Actually, there's a chapter in the book which explains all of this, explains why she's suffering from arthritis and how she can reverse the arthritis pain.
I'm going to get my mother a copy of this book.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
Forever Painless, Lasting Relief Through Gentle Movement is what it's called. If you're just joining us, we've got Miranda Esmond White. She's the host of Classical Stretch, the creator of the Eccentrics. Eccentrics.
No, Eccentrics.
It's for the wackadoodles out there. Workout, and the author of a book that I've interviewed you before on aging backwards. And so now we're talking about pain. What is pain?
Pain is a message.
Besides that hellish feeling.
It's nothing. Pain is nothing. It's just a message telling us that there is something wrong with our body. What has happened is that we are trying to turn the message off. Mm. But we should actually be listening to the message. Like, there's chronic pain and acute pain. Acute pain happens like you have an injury, an accident, a disease, burns, breaks, and you know exactly why you're in pain, and it's right there then in front of you. Chronic pain is pain that's lasted for more than 3 months, and often chronic pain lasts years and years. So that's what this book is all about, and 80% of pain is chronic pain.
I'm going to get a copy for my mama and my boy toy.
Oh, good.
He's got pain too.
Well, we don't have to be in pain.
No.
Pain is the 80% of pain, which we're talking about, is mechanical pain, not chemistry pain. And it can be reversed, in most cases, totally reversed, definitely relieved, just through correct mechanical movement. And it needs relaxed movement also. So people work too hard when they're trying to get out of pain. They have to be very gentle on their body. Because if you think about it, if you have something wrong, why would you push it? Attack it harder.
Because we're so mad that we're in pain.
You have to be sweet with it. You have to be loving with your pain.
And you can't just drug it away.
No. Oh, drug, bad idea, because then you don't know you've got something wrong.
You don't realize that it's got an actually worse.
You're making it worse if you drug it away.
But you can understand why people do take whatever they take, because I got to get in the car. I got to go to work. I got to get this done. I got to take the kid to the hockey game. Blah.
So you do the same thing. You take your pain relief medication, but you work on getting it healed. So you actually don't just do the medication, but you heal yourself.
I was thinking about you before the show started, Miranda, because I think one of the things that you are suggesting, which I think we're all as a society we could be doing a better job at, is just the moment of self-care.
Right.
So, for example, and I'll use my boyfriend as an example. He's got to get out. He's got to get to work. He woke up this morning. He's in pain. His mattress isn't serving him well. He wants to just take a pill and go.
Right.
And that's all understandable.
Right.
We're all in that sort of position where we've got things to do, responsibilities, and we've got to make things happen. But what you're saying is take some time for you. That stretching, that, you know, and we don't do enough of that.
Stretching and strengthening. Yeah. And all you need to do is about 10 or 15 minutes every day. Yeah. Like, we can brush our teeth, wash our faces,
Watch the Real Housewives, and
you can actually do them at the same time. But you just add another 10 or 15 minutes to your schedule to do these eccentrics, lengthening and strengthening. All the exercises are in the book, and you will reverse that pain. Your boyfriend should not be in pain. He is too young.
You hear that, babe?
Yeah, he should not be in pain. People get out of pain when they do correct rebalancing exercises. Their pain goes away in, like, sometimes instantly, and sometimes it takes 2 or 3 weeks, sometimes longer. But you do not have to be in pain, but you have to do, you have to strengthen your muscles, realign your joints, or you will remain in pain because the body is complaining that
look
something's
wrong. Look at this boyfriend
wrong.
In pain this morning.
I say to him,
if you can take time when you first wake up in the morning for a selfie, well, he's doctored it. He's doctored it. This is what he really looked like.
You can see more about the book.
Now that's nice.
Yeah. You like that?
Yeah, that's nice. The
that's
other one
good, right?
Looks very unhappy.
But if you've got time to take selfies in the morning, sweetheart, you've got time to do a few stretches.
Totally. Yeah.
Because I'm tired of hearing about your back.
You can see more about the book at classicalstretch.com. It is called Forever Painless. New York Times best-selling author Miranda Esmond White. Pretty kick ass to be a New York Times bestseller, just telling people to move, you know, to tell them what someone should have been telling them all along.
I know.
You know?
Yeah, it was a big thrill, actually, to.
Of course it was. Congratulations. Yeah.
We'll also tweet out eccentrics.com.
Right.
Also find out about it there. I, like I said, it was something that I didn't even realize. I went to a personal trainer of all things and was like, yeah, I've had this side pain lately, and, you know, I think it's the way I stand or whatever. And it was actually him who noticed it. He had me lay down. He went, you know, your pelvis is tilted. And I didn't know that. And I went to a doctor and had it checked out. Sure enough, it is.
When I saw you today, I was like, geez, your pelvis wore tilted. Yeah. At Miranda C. Stretch on Twitter, will you come back for another interview in 10 minutes when you've got another book out?
Right, absolutely. It's on the way. Thank you so much for having me.
Nice to see you. Nice to see you again.
Great having you here. Check it out. Forever Painless is the new book. And we will be right back. Sean Prue is filling in for Al. This is Ward and Al, and you're listening to Canada Talks.